Hey friends, Anthony from Figma here, and my present to you today is to talk about presentations. If you didn't already know, Figma is an awesome tool for building presentations. You can use a lot of the same prototyping features, so the present button to present your presentation, building your frames at presentation size. There's lots of really great examples in the community. There's lots of great writing out there, so I'm not going to spend too much time on that. And the one that I want to focus on today is the ability to nest interactions, prototype interactions inside of our presentation, right? So here we have a series of frames that represent our presentation. If we go to present this, you'll see that we have our presentation. I can use the arrow keys to move back and forward between them. And then I have a page here where I'm actually demoing a screen. And what's cool is I can actually scroll this on this frame of the presentation. I can actually go through and look at what this is going to look like. And the way that we're doing that is with some of the prototyping features inside of Figma. So here, you'll notice that none of these other frames have prototyping connections. In fact, we're in prototyping mode, so you can see that there's no connections between these. That's what allows us to use the arrow keys to move between them. But when we get to this frame here, we actually have this nested frame inside of this called homepage. And this here is a full design, and this actually has our overflow property set for vertical scrolling. So I'm able to scroll this whole design, but it doesn't look like there's much here. Let's make a copy of this real quick, and you're gonna see here, this entire frame is actually clipping all of the additional content that's below it. So if I turn off clip content, you're gonna see that we have the whole frame of content down here, and we have in prototyping mode that vertical scrolling property applied. This is very similar to what you would do for a full prototype, right? If you were trying to build out an actual example of this, you'd use a lot of these same properties, but it's kind of a cool use case to see it inside of a presentation frame here. So when we reapply clip content, we're able to see that clipped. We also have the menu down here is being set to fixed position to stay at the bottom of this frame, as you can see here in this example. So when we nest that inside of our presentation, it just works as expected. So we're able to present and actually see that scrolling behavior right inside of our frame as we're presenting. This extends to a lot of other nested interaction properties as well, so things like interactive components. We're not going to cover that now, but I highly recommend checking that out and seeing how it might help in this scenario as well. Hope that helps, and happy presenting.